Hey, it's Kaylee, and this lesson is on the water cycle. Let's see what the big deal is about water on Earth. Rain is a very important part of Earth's weather. Rain helps move water through the water cycle, connecting the ocean, land, and atmosphere. Let's see what it's all about. It is important for scientists to know where it rains and snows, and how the rivers and streams are flowing, and where water is stored on Earth. By taking measurements of water depths and how much rain and snow falls, scientists are able to determine changes in Earth's climate. In simple words, the water cycle describes how water evaporates from Earth's surface into the sky, then it cools and condenses into rain or snow clouds. Then it falls back to the earth as precipitation, rain or snow. The water that falls to earth is then stored in lakes, in soil, and on porous rocks. The water eventually makes its way back to the ocean and then is evaporated again. Let's start with a deeper look into evaporation. Evaporation happens when liquid water heats up and becomes water vapor. But this idea of water turning into vapor, rising into the atmosphere, doesn't only happen from bodies of water like oceans and lakes. Plants can suck water up into them from the soil. This movement of water from the soil to the plant is called plant uptake. After plant uptake, water can also be turned into water vapor and is lifted to the atmosphere from plants. This is called transpiration. Sometimes when it snows, the air temperature is so warm, the snow turns into water vapor and is brought back up into the atmosphere. This is called sublimation. In this picture, these arrows represent evaporation from water, transpiration from plants, and sublimation from snow. When the water vapor cools to become water droplets, it is called condensation. These water droplets are stored in clouds as rain or snow. When water moves through the atmosphere but doesn't fall to the earth, it's called vapor transports. These arrows represent water condensating, and this arrow represents vapor transport, moving from one cloud to the next. The next stage in the water cycle is precipitation. Precipitation can be rain, snow, or hail falling from clouds. Sometimes, when it's very cold, water vapor can turn directly into snow or ice and fall to the earth. That process is called deposition. In this picture, this arrow represents snow precipitation. This arrow represents rain precipitation, and this represents deposition. When a cloud of tiny water droplets is very close to the ground, it is called fog. Sometimes dew can form. Dew is when water vapor has condensed into water droplets on an object. The last stage of the water cycle is collection or storage of water on Earth's surface. This happens by streams or rivers, which bring the water that fell to the Earth to large storage areas like oceans and lakes. Water can also drain over the surface of the Earth. This is called runoff. This is an example of a stream, and this is an example of runoff. When water soaks into the soil, it's called infiltration. And as water moves through the rocks and the soil, it's called percolation. The water is then stored beneath the earth here, and it's called groundwater. As the groundwater moves towards larger storage areas, it's called groundwater flow. Once the water is collected and in storage, the sun comes out and is a source of heat and energy. As the temperatures heat up, the water cycle can start all over again. Here is a labeled graphic of the water cycle for you to study. Feel free to pause the video and sketch a copy into your science notebook. Keep practicing what you have learned about the water cycle by playing our games and taking the online quizzes. And remember to always be clever. Hey, hey.